He was a very, very, very quiet guy. He a very, very nice person. Somebody you never thought that would have done that. He always smiles. I guess we have that in us. We always smile when we speak. You could never sense any problems coming from him. Every time you ask him how is everything, he always says everything is okay, you know, but you would have to ask him because he doesn't really just come up and speak to you and say things are not all that good, you know. But he was, there was never a negative feeling around him, you know. He was just with everybody. This just took us, the family, by storm, you know. It's like we just don't know what happened. We don't know what triggered it. We don't know why he did it. We wish he had at least told somebody or write a note letting us know what was going on with him, you know? Because I've always been there with them. I've always been there for them. I mean, I'm the only sister that they have, you know, and I just wish he would say. But you know, the guys don't really say. The guys don't really say what's bothering them because they have that kind of macho and that ego thing about them, you know, so they don't really say. But I just want to let the men know out there that we, the women, are there for them, the mothers are there for them, the sisters, and if they have any problem or anything, they don't have to say everything, but we can sense little thing as women. So the moment they speak to us, we can sense something is going on.
Mikey was a very quiet kind of fella. I mean, he's always on his own vibe. He does his own thing. And it really amazes, it shocks me to know that he has taken his life. It's a sad day in the community. And I hope that his family can be strong and you know. Oh man, that's sad. That's just sad. You know, things like that happen and you get really sad to know that it happens that close to you. And you know, what if you could have done something to prevent it from happening? But I give the family strength and encouragement in this time and hope that they could go through this and God be with them.
As far as you know, did he have any particular problems or?
I'm not too aware. Mike is his own person, like I said. You know, he'd see you, he'd talk to you, he'd smile. He's always smiling. Always has, he always greets people. He's a very polite guy in the community, and I'm amazed by this. I'm really taken aback by it.
But a person who is quiet and reserved, kind of.
Yeah, he's that kind of. He's not really reserved. He's quiet. He's into his own world. If he meets you and you know him, he would speak with you. He always have a little joke. He's always smiling. That's the thing about it. So you know, it puzzles you that somebody who's always smiling, and that just goes to say that sometimes we see people who smile, but we're not aware of what's happening inside of them. So you know, I think this is a message, just a notion that we should really take time to care about each other, you know, speak to each other, find out what's going on, because somebody might be going through the worst of things, and you wouldn't know.